What's up, guys? It's Touch of Touches Workshop, and in this video, we're going to make a fixture for the CNC machine, and then we're going to route out three bender lower arms. I've been doing a lot of work with this thing, so I figure while I'm doing it, might as well make some videos on it. You know what I mean? But anyways, guys, what I've got here is I've got a piece of wood, and I've got a piece of aluminum. This is an inch by 12 by quarter. And that's what I used for the lower arms. Now what we've got to do is we've got to take this piece here and I'm going to mount it to the CNC machine, and then we're going to run a facing tool path. And basically all that's going to do is when this thing's mounted, the router is going to actually travel all the way around the top of this thing and flatten it to the machine. And the reason we do that is so this piece isn't cattywampus when you put it on there. If you don't know what cattywampus is, look it up. It's an Urban Dictionary. It means askew or crooked. So maybe that's just Alabama coming out of me. I don't know. A lot of you guys ask where I'm from. I'm from Alabama. I am. And my accent gives it away, I guess. But anyways, I'm going to turn the camera here in just a second and kind of show you what I mean in the tool path on Fusion 360. And then we're going to go out in the shop and we're going to run it. And it's freezing cold in here, too. I don't have any heat except for this little space heater. So and I can't run that while I'm talking to you guys because it's so freaking loud. But anyways, we're going to turn this thing around. I'm going to show it to you. All right, so basically this is what we got here. And it's not hard at all, but what I did is I came in here to the model, and I basically just made this piece to match this piece. So I did that. I made it just a little bit bigger, just so when I'm putting this thing on there, maybe it won't be as, I won't have to be as accurate of getting it centered. Once I got done doing that, I came in here and I went to manufacture. Setup, I made a stock piece for it, and all I did was it's the same thickness, but I went over a quarter on all the sides. And the reason I do that is because when the tool path makes, I wanted to make sure I get every part of this on here. Now if you look at the tool path, this is basically all it is. It's just facing the top, and it's a very easy tool path, and it's not anything hard about this tool path. It's very, very simple. Okay, so here we are outside. Now I took the file from inside and I brought it out here with a USB drive. I'm gonna come here, I'm gonna load the G code into Mach 3. And you see right here it says fixture for lower arm face right there. And then you're gonna see, if I go to toolpath, it's kinda hard to tell, but you see it right there. You can actually see the part. But anyway, so now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get the part set up on the CNC machine. So I've got that in here. Now all we gotta do is set the part up. All right, so I've got the part. And all I did basically was just take it and countersink some holes here and then drill them out to where I can mount this thing. I just want it mounted right next to this guy here. And we're gonna put it on. So here's our part right here. Now what I want to do is I want to zero the machine, or zero at least the X and the Y. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to move my machine over. All right. Now I want to get it as close to this corner as I set up. This is my corner for the where it's zeroed out at. Now I'm going to bring this over. And this is the reason why I add a little bit to it too, so where I can, if I'm a little bit off on this part, it's okay. So that is my Y. I'm gonna zero the Y. Now let's zero the X. Actually, that's good. I'm gonna zero right on it, right there. Now I'm centering this thing up. I'm centering it up halfway through the bit. So the bits, halfway in the center of the bit is where I want the to be lined up at. So if you imagine the center of the bit is where it's at. Now to get the zero on the Z, I'm gonna bring this thing down just a little bit and try to get it to where it's gonna take off, like maybe, I don't know, maybe an eighth of an inch, if that, maybe less than that. So I'm gonna say about right in there. And I'm going to zero the Z. So now we have zeroed everything out. All right, the most important thing, don't forget about these. I'll never run this thing without these on. So here we go.
There it goes. Now I'm just going to take a piece of sandpaper and basically flatten off the ridges on it. Just a flat block here. There's me. Now what I want to do is I want to get a straight line on here. The best way I've always figured to do that
is to basically take this mask and everything off. It's basically set this router up here, right on the edge of this. And I don't know if you saw it or not, this is a little bit crooked. I thought this was more straight than it was. I'm just going to take it and I'm going to go down just a little bit and run the router all the way across it just by my hand and get a straight edge right here. And that way when I line this part, on here, at least I know it is straight with the x-axis. So that way I know when I put it on there, I'm not on there like this, and when this thing starts routing, it digs way into the material right here. So that's what I'm going to do next. Down. You don't have to be very deep, just as long as it's a line there. All right, so I'm going to cut it back on, and I'm just going to run it across by hitting this button right here. Now I can align this with that line there, and as long as I'm close, I should be all right. But that way it gives me somewhere to mount.
Use this on the back of here to clean off any oil or anything like that on it.
Usually what I do on this is, especially after I just routed this piece, so I just take a piece of tape and stick it on there and then pull it back off and get rid of if there was any. See all the dust that was on it? You just throw that one away. And then with this one, I actually try to be accurate with it. Try to get it where I want it. Now I just align that edge right here up with the edge we created on the part there. Try to get it as close as possible. That way I know at least I'm straight there. Just kind of burnish it. Just take that and just run it off. As close as I can. This Gorilla stuff takes about, probably 10 seconds or so to hold down. All right, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to load up the next line of G-code to route this part. And basically, same process I did a while ago. I've got it on my USB drive. I'm gonna bring it in here. Now, unplug the router, because I don't wanna, just to be safe. I'm gonna turn this bit to where I can almost see, like, kind of as it's at an angle, or if it's straight, dead center of the part. Looks good for the x-axis. So we're gonna zero our x on our Mach 3 here. Now I need to do the y-axis. Looks pretty good. I'm going to zero Y. The reason I don't have to be exact with that right now because I added the extra stock. So you might see this bit go around the part a couple times before it actually starts going to the part. And that's just for the purpose of if I'm not exactly right, I'm mounting this thing perfectly square, perfectly accurate, at zero and everything. At least it's not going to just dive right into a bunch of material at one time. Now, in order to zero the Z, make sure you can see that there. All right, we're going to bring it over here to our material top. We'll bring it up a little bit. And then I'm going to bring it down. I'm going to get a sheet of paper. I'm going to cut the machine off so I can move this arm here. I'm just going to start lowering it by hand. And then I feel it biting on the paper, right there, I'm gonna call that zero. Now that's our Z zero. Our Z is what everybody calls it. I can call it that, I guess. It sounds weird. Okay, now I'm gonna zero the Z. So now, I bring this thing up, and I hit go to zero, it should go right back to that beginning right there. So everything's aligned, everything's good. I gotta change this bit out because we don't use that for our first bit. We use an 1/8-inch drill bit for our first process. So, I zeroed this, but there's the wrong part. Like I said, I got ahead of myself. And lower it, and about right there. So able to go to zero again and see the same places. Okay. Put all our stuff back on here. All right, there's our part. Now the next thing I do is I tap all these holes. All right, got those tapped. All right, now the next process I do is I sand these things down. Start out with about a 220 grit. This isn't necessary, but I mean, I think that's kind of my favorite part because you're actually making the piece pretty, kind of, I guess. So, anyway. And the next part is my favorite part of the whole process, and it's the part where this thing really starts to shine. So I'm going to move over here to my buffing wheel. There's our final piece. So, like I said, it's not perfect, but it looks pretty good. I think it's pretty enough for inside of a guitar, but when somebody does open it and see it, they'll think, oh, that looks good. So there it is. Well, all right, guys, there's the process to make this one little part here. Which, like I said, I've got making it to where I can make three of these at a time now. But hopefully, I won't have more. I've got it figured out, I hope. So anyways, this is actually Rock Forester's arm, lower lever, I guess I should say. And then here's the knob. I'm probably going to make one of these in the next video. Just to show y'all how easy it is to make one of these knobs if you want to make one yourself. It won't be no problem. But this one's actually John McAmis. It's his lower arm. And I've got to make another knob and for this one. So there it is, guys. Guys, if you have any questions or comments about any of the stuff that I did in this video, just let me know. I'll go more in depth on any of the CNC stuff or the Fusion 360, whatever you want to do. Guys, hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, give me a like. And if you like it, please subscribe. Thanks for watching, guys.